guys, and welcome back. Today we'll take a look again at Xerath on the Public Test Realm and his reworked Zathiei map again on the PB, on the test servers. And actually, as my main mage, I was very curious to see what has changed again since his last rework. So we have new animations now. And for the other skins too, I will show them in another video. For now, I wanted to tell you again the numbers, and I want to show you how the skills work, etc. So, guys, but also remember that we have this is still the public test realm. Everything can change. This is barely a view of how of what direction they want to take the new Xerath. So, let's start. We have his passive, Overwhelming Power. Every 12 seconds, Xerath's basic attack restores 81 mana. Overwhelming Power restores 162 mana if attacking champions. So, that remains the same. So, his passive is that he gains some mana back when he hits a champion. Let me show you. I will cast his Q over there. So, let's go attack our friend Yasuo there. Yeah, he's full. So, but this has been fixed on the previous rework. You could take back the exact portion of mana that the passive told you. For example, if the passive told you that you will earn back 180 mana, if you had 160 mana, the proc didn't go off. But that's fixed. So even if it overheals you, it will still go off. Now, let's go to the Arcano pools. With the first cast, Xerath charges Arcano pools, gradually decreasing his movement speed while increasing the spell charge. Second cast, Xerath fires Arcano pools, dealing 240 magic damage to all enemies in a line. While charging Arcano pools, Xerath cannot attack or cast other spells. If Xerath does not fire the spell, half the mana cost is refunded. So, you can see the minimum range of the spell and the maximum range of the spell. And right now, if I don't cast the spell, half of the mana cost is refunded. So let me show you again. The spell costs 130 mana. I will click it, but not shoot it. See, I got some mana back. But now I want to show you again the movement speed reduction of the Arcano pools. If you see, the more I hold the Q, the less his movement speed is. They wanted to make it as a trade-off for the increased accuracy if you keep holding Q. But you can see the range. The basic range is this one, the inner circle. The outer range is the outer circle. So let me show you. Let me stand over here. I can hit Yasuo from over here. There. Bam. Okay. Let's go now to his second skill, Locus of Destruction. Xerath calls down a blast of arcane energy, dealing 120 magic damage and applying 10% movement speed slow to all enemies within the raid target. With target area, enemies in the center of the blast take 192 magic damage and are slowed by 50%. So this works like the Leona's ultimate. When you hit someone with the inner circle, they take more damage and they are slowed much more. So, if we hit Yasuo like this, for example, he took a certain quantity of damage. He took 120 damage. Let's say, let's hit that again. You see the damage that he takes with the outer circle. 92 damage. Alright. So we'll hit again with the inner circle and see the increase in damage. So let's go with the inner circle. He takes 150. See? Alright. So his third skill, Stasis Orb. Seraph fires an orb of raw magic. The first enemy hits takes 80 magic damage and stuns between 0.75 and 2 seconds. The stun duration lengthens based on how far the orb travels. So, actually, if I fire it from. Let's go a bit more. Forward. If I fire it from over here, he stuns for the entire duration, 2 seconds. But if I fire it from over here. Wait a second. You see that the stun is more or less. So, let's go now to the. This is like the mage chains that he had at his basic kit, but now it's a skill shot, and you don't need to hit the enemy with another spell in order to stun. Okay, so now let me show you the ultimate. Ascension. Xerath ascends to his true form, become eroded in place, and gain 3 arcane barrages. This magic artillery deals 190 magic damage to all enemies hit. If arcane barrage only hits single target, it deals 25 extra damage. The route ends after 6 seconds when all shots have been fired or when manually deactivated by issuing a move command. If Xerath does not fire off a single arcane barrage, half of the cooldown of Ascension is refunded. So what that actually means is that they heard the feedback of the players on the first Valorant build, and when actually the ultimate was in ultra long cooldown as n like now, but when you don't fire even a single shot of the ultimate, you don't lose the entire cooldown. So now it refunds half of the cooldown duration if the ultimate does not go off. But you have to remember that if you right click at any point during the ultimate cancels. So you have to be very careful about that. So now, as you can see over here, his range is incredible. So it fires around the outer circle, the outer ring of the Dominar map. And at the level 3, his range is increased even more. So let me show you now the ultimate on our friendly Yeshua here. One, two, and let's shoot over there. Three. So when we shoot three barrages, the ultimate ends, and it goes on cooldown normally. So that's the skill set as for now. Many chains I believe will come. Most probably his build is in very primal form until now. They need a lot of feedback in order to finalize it. But as it stands now, it's in decent form. Although there are no sounds and a lot of things are missing, I will try to make some games and take a look at how his lane phase is for now. And take a look at his kit, how it works in a normal game. And actually, with his new passive, I don't see why Xerath can't be a support. Poking everyone with his ultra long range and his stuns and with his stun, sorry. And his AOS low and everything there. I think he should. He if they if his kit remains the same, he must be one of the toughest supports ever. And since we have level 3 range, I think yeah, his range is like that. Okay, so guys, thank you for joining me. I really hope you enjoyed this episode and find it informative. I will keep this post updated with any new. Any information that we have on Xerath's work. And as always, guys, I will see you next time. Goodbye, guys.